Dire team pick.
Faceless Void.
Team Secrets turn to pick.
Right.
All right, welcome back. We've got an interesting matchup here between Team Secret and Team Toast. The match of the two teams. One is known, the other is still a secret. And we are in the quarterfinals of the EU Open Qualifier to the International 2016. We'll be getting into this draft right now. Team Toast going for a first pick, Faceless Void. Could be paired up with a Phoenix is generally the combo that we see. I'm Pythian, going to be bringing you this match off of Dota TV as well as on twitch.tv/PythianLegume. Team Secret, go for a first pick, blue Tidehunter. Interesting pickup from him. It's a hero that we haven't seen so much, but they may go for a Tidehunter Phoenix. Could be the combo, or it might be something else that they decide to work with in this game. Without the Phoenix being banned out, I have a feeling that either team could go for it. And yep, it's going to be a Tidehunter Phoenix from Team Secret. That's going to be the combo that Team Toast have to fight into. Could be a little bit difficult in lane. Tidehunter can very easily go over towards the hard camp, get the anchor smash onto the creeps, and use the Iron Talons as well to do some pretty good farming and get the levels up. Very important for Tidehunter to get a good level 6, good Ravage, and then some farm past that. Some of them will choose to go for Drums, a Mech. A Blink Dagger is usually the most common, but there's still a lot of things that they can do here, and BlueBlue is actually playing fairly well. His Darkseer in the last game did very well for Secret, and it probably had a big part in them winning the game, as he had some very key vacuums as they got towards the later parts of the game.
Juggernaut.
Give me a Juggernaut from Team Toast. So they already go for two of their cores. It's going to be a Faceless Void and a Juggernaut. Now Team Secret have a lot of time to actually react to this. Juggernaut, he can get the spinoff before Tidehunter gets the stun on him for the ult. And Faceless Void, he can get interrupted inside the Chronosphere, but at least they have something to go for the Phoenix. So Juggernaut can spin, and then he already has a high base attack time, so he can kill the Phoenix Egg fairly well. Maybe if there's like one other hero that Team Toast pick up to help him out there, things would be a little bit better. But that does bring us into the second banning phase. It's going to be a Disruptor from Team Secret. Very strong hero, has lots of catch, can be good against the Phoenix as well as the Tidehunter. Drop that Static Storm down. Very good in team fights. Interesting that they also banned out the Elder Titan against the Toast Boys.
10 seconds remaining.
Using a lot of time to think about these bans. Puppy has been known as one of the draft kings in recent days, or the recent era. Team Toast are going to take the Alchemist out. A hero that can get farmed fairly quickly. And may possibly spell a bit of a comeback mechanic for Team Secret. Sometimes it's difficult to take the Alchemist down, and he's a little bit easier in the early game, but when he comes back into the match, I mean, yesterday I saw an Alchemist nearly come back against TWM. He went 0-9 in the first couple of minutes, and then found a couple of kills, then found a lot of farm, and made life very difficult for them. In the end, TWM did get the victory, but it was not without difficulty for them. Team Secret now ban out a Tinker.
5 seconds remaining.
And it's a hero that could be good in the mid lane. Invoker is still in the pool. We saw Arteezy playing Invoker last game, when they ban out Puppy's axe. Couple of topical bans there. They do pick up the Invoker for Archeezy on the mid lane. Again, some more team fight control. Lane Dominator at mid. We'll see how it goes for him. I remember when Archeezy just started practicing Invoker. He's got some good mechanics, but he just had to get more used to the hero. And he's been playing it well here. I think he definitely has a lot more room to improve, and I'm not an Invoker by any means, but could be doing a couple of different things on the map and a couple of different mechanically things that we do see experienced Invoker players like Weeha or other such players doing. Something like Dendi, maybe. So it's going to be an Artur Invoker. I believe that most of these people for Team Toast have been on Cookie Squad, which have done fairly well in most of these qualifiers. Been getting to the later stages pretty much every single time. But I don't think they've actually been able to make it through the regional qualifier at any point. Taking a lot of time on this next pickup from Team Toast. They're going to be down to 20 seconds on the reserve time. Really wanting to not waste a pick here. They do still have to go for their two supports, and one of them is going to be the Vengeful Spirit. Able to swap out heroes, maybe away from the Tidehunter Ultimate, out of the Phoenix Supernova. Definitely could be a good pickup here. Helps also out the team out with the damage and puts the debuff on the other team when she dies. Good stun in the early game. And also some minus armor, which can help the Faceless Void inside the Chronosphere, as well as the Juggernaut and all the damage that he's putting out. Could make him start to hit pretty hard. Continuing through the draft. Team Secret still have to go for a support and then their carry for Envy. Envy has quite a wide hero pool. He's been playing a lot of different heroes. See him on a Quinx a couple of times. He wasn't on the Slark last game. And the way he plays, he just is always fairly sure of when his team needs to go in, and sometimes they just have to follow him. Can be difficult to do that since he might be a bit too enthusiastic at times about where he needs to initiate, what he's doing in a game. But with a team that trusts him, Envy can be pretty good.
Lion.
Dire team pick.
The Pylai Dai Lion gets picked up for Team Secret. They're going to wait on Envy's hero, which is kind of predictable. Team Toast are going to have their fourth pickup here fairly quickly. They still probably need a mid laner unless they send Juggernaut there, but I have a feeling that a Juggernaut versus Invoker is a matchup that, while the Juggernaut may be able to get the advantage at some point, I don't think it's good enough to necessarily warrant him going against the Archeezy Invoker. And they do pick up the Death Prophet now for the mid lane. There are ways for a Juggernaut to do well against Invoker, but I don't think that it's something that you would try in a quarterfinal to in an open qualifier.
10 seconds remaining.
Death Prophet now picked up by Team Toast gives them some pushing here. And with the death, with the healing ward from Juggernaut and the minus armor and damage R from Vengeful Spirit, they do have some pretty good pushing available now. And Team Secret, Phoenix is okay with wave clear, same with the Tidehunter. They do have to be worried about that swap, though. 5 seconds remaining.
Dire team pick.
A couple bans out. The EE Slark banned out by Team Toast, and there's going to be an Earth Spirit taken out of the draft by Poppy. Night Stalker.
Team Secrets turn to pick.
Night Stalker now from Team Toast. They really want to punish Eternal Envy or the Invoker, just trying to create space on the map, and Invoker may have another difficult game on his hands. If Nightstalker is able to get to an Aghanim Scepter and a gem, Team Secret might have another difficult game on their hands. Drow Ranger. That's going to be a Drow Ranger for Eternal Envy. So they pick this one up late, going to give a lot of damage over to the team, and they're going to try to do push with reward push with push. They're going to go right on to Team Toast. Silence is good, but I think Nightstalker silence might be a little bit better when he gets the night vision. This is going to be the test of who is able to get the better push and who has the better sustaining damage. Drow Ranger definitely has to be careful of this Team Toast combo. Oh, as always, we'll see what Eternal Envy ends up doing here. In just a moment, we will start up with this quarterfinal matchup between Team Toast and Team Secret.
5 seconds remaining.
All right, here we go. We're going to get into this match and already paused out. As the Faceless Void needs to pick his hero, maybe not be AFK. And in terms of draft, both teams really want to go for a push. I have a feeling that if this goes late game, Team Toast are probably going to have the advantage. Drow Ranger really can tend to fall off in the late game depending on positioning. So we'll see if that happens. Bulbu already going to the top lane, trying to put his Observer Ward down. And he's going to get it near the hard camp. It's not Envision of the Rune, but is going to see something here. And the Dire basically prays the same ward on the other side of the map. This one's in a little bit better position. Alright, so we're getting into this match. Let's introduce our heroes a little bit. We've got Solon on the Vengeful Spirit. E-Skills will be playing the Death Prophet. Faceless Void in the offlane handled by Kefka. Juggernaut played by Flens at top. And finally, the Night Stalker. That's going to be played by Steph Style. Here for Team Secret, Phoenix is going to be Puppy. Got an Eternal Envy Drow Ranger, Pylai Dai playing the Lion. Artur is going to be on the Invoker. And finally, Bulbu will be playing Tidehunter at top. We're going to get moving with this game in just a couple seconds. Team Secret probably going to go for the rune at bottom. Giving it over to Arteezy. And E-Skills will get the rune at top. Not interested at fighting in the runes at all here. I'd probably still put the advantage to Team Secret as they have some ridiculous damage with that precision. Arteezy himself is doing 66 damage per hit with that aura. He's going to have a pretty good last hit in the mid lane compared to Death Prophet 65, so they're very even. And the block is about even as well. So we'll get into this game. We've got Arteezy getting the first last hit, and Peanuts Almighty already having trouble staying in the lobby. Bulbu just trying to get some some XP here at top. He's already picked up one level into the Kraken shell, and there's going to be a stun here from the Vengeful Spirit. Bulbu's taking a lot of damage from this, but he can't really pursue, and Bulbu uses the healing salve, and it's going to be completely fine there. Just look at how much damage Arteezy does to E-Skills at mid. Doing a lot of damage to her, lots of harass. Drow is helping him out quite a bit. Another stun is not available just yet from Vengeful Spirit. We'll have it in a couple of mana, and Juggernaut cannot spin for a little bit either. But they will have their combo up in a second, and Bulbu doesn't have another healing salve. Now, over at bottom, the Eternal Envy is basically getting a free lane. Kefka has been forced off of the lane. And Eternal Envy is getting some pretty good farm here. So if he can get his farm up very quickly, might start to create problems for Team Toast. They really want to keep this Drow Ranger down. She is basically the key to Team Secret's success in this early game. And it's going to be the life suck onto Artur. He uses a cold snap. It's pretty even harass there. Baseless Void finds an invisibility rune over at top. And the spin is wasted by Juggernaut as well. Guess he was expecting a stun from Vengeful Spirit, but it wasn't really there. Over at bottom, Kefka is just going to scout out this hard camp. Puppy is rather low on health. Kefka doesn't decide to go in on it. Almost like he's baiting it. Kefka hasn't leveled up his second skill just yet. Seems to be waiting on it. Be a stun from Lion. Maybe Kefka could steal a creep or two. Yeah, he will get one. And with the stun down from Pileidai, Kefka doesn't have to worry about this. And the first blood goes down at mid. Death Prophet finds a Crypt Swarm onto Arteezy, as well as the Spirit Siphon. And that is going to be one on the Arteezy death counter.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
He will get right back to that mid lane. Unfortunately, not able to be that aggressive onto the Death Prophet. And he's almost at level 4. And the faster you can get the levels up on Invoker, the better he is. That is generally true for most heroes, but Invoker especially depends on it, since most of his actual spells are determined by the levels of his other, of his elements. That just makes the levels even more important. Things are quieting down here. Very quiet start to the game. 4 minutes in, and it's 1-0. That first blood onto Arteezy. Death Prophet goes over to the rune. Is having a couple, well, lots of things delivered on the courier. That's one boot and a magic stick for her. And Sullen is going to scout out Bulbu at the hard camp. Tries to give him the minus armor on the creep. And Bulbu still manages to get the last hit. Regen rune popped by Death Prophet, so she's going to have more harass here on mid. And is the courier going to get sniped by the Night Stalker? Not there. Not that time. Eternal Envy, almost level 6. He is going to get a Ring of Basilius delivered to him on the courier, so that will be his Ring of Aquila finished up. And that gives him some pushing power if he turns the aura on. As well as some damage and regen of mana and armor. Lots of things there with that item. Gonna help him with his early farm. Basically left Juggernaut alone at top though for that. He's got a phase boots and is working towards possibly a battle fury. I have a feeling that would be one of the first items from Juggernaut. To get that farm up as fast as possible. Jason's Void's still not yet level 4, and Jar Ranger is at level 6, so there'll be a lot of damage that could be done here. Steph Style's ready. He's got a silence available. It's nighttime. Rest of Secret, they might be ready. Eternal Envy is pretty good aggressive, and he's going to go into the side shop, could pick out the Night Stalker, and does he have vision? Go over to the top trying to look for him. Night Stalker is just going to go further into the trees, and they decide that it's time to go for the tower. The damage is there with the Drow Ranger marksmanship. TP comes in. Night Stalker coming in from the backside. He's going to get silence on the Pywai Dai. There's an Exorcism available. Time dilation is there. Eternal Envy about to go down. Spirit Siphon is there. And they come in from behind. They take the kill onto Eternal Envy, and they stop that push onto the Tier 1 tower. Arteezy is going through these creeps. He's at level 6 right now. Still getting him up. The Exorcism has come back into the mid lane, so they did not push a tower off that at all. Instead, just deciding to go back to mid. And there's a spin on Bulbulu at top. Trying to get to level 6. This match is still pretty quiet. Juggernaut leading the last hits, Drow Ranger not too far behind. And Arteezy's gotten a few more at mid with the Death Prophet going around the map, a slight bit more. Eternal Envy moves forward at bottom. He's going right for the tower. Tower is taking a lot of damage. They could take it down fairly quickly. Faceless Void almost at level 6. There's a 4-5, but not much other help. The Courier is going to see Steph Style in the jungle. And the tower gets taken by Drow Ranger. So the first tower of the game goes the way of Team Secret. And Eternal Envy is doing pretty well in the net worth. They go over to the hard camp. I'm going to use the laser to finish it off. And Eternal Envy not quite getting the farm. He kind of wants that. That might help him out a little bit. Radiant's Courier gets killed by Nightstalker. He was just sitting in the jungle waiting for it. And there's going to be no punish. He's also just waiting on the high ground, waiting for the Phoenix to get even closer. Bounty Rune for Lion, Illusion for Death Prophet. We're 8 minutes into the game, and the first tower of the game has gone the way of Team Secret. Drow Ranger sitting on Morbid Mask. It'll be interesting to see what she decides to go for. I have a feeling it's just going to be a on the Dominator, probably not the Mask of Madness that was so common a while ago. Phoenix is going to laser down the creeps, and the silence is not leveled up for Death Prophet. They just force the Phoenix away from the lane, and they start to push in top, but Arteezy is ready to push in mid, and the Drow Ranger rotates over to mid as well. Tower gets fortified, Drow Ranger is ready for mid, doing basically equal damage here. The top tier one goes down first. The TP is available if they decide to go in. Faceless Void ready with the Chronosphere. Let's see if it hits. There's also a Ravage, level 7 Tidehunter. He's gotten to level 7 at this time. And are they able to find it in an eye? They may go for it. Nope, it is not there. Invoker finds the last hit. Arteezy secures it. And that's just a tower trade. It's kind of what I thought was going to happen when I saw this match. And okay, Lion picks up the finger. He's not got an Earth Spike, and he's going to get slowed down here by the Faceless Void if he turns around at all. They're actually going to use a Chronosphere for this, so that's probably a win for Team Secret. But Lion is going to go back to hell. Bit of a lull in the action once again. This game is really focused around tower pushes. And with an Exorcism down, Team Toast aren't really going to go for one. And Envy's still got to get his farm around the map. Bulbu working on his item. Picked up a magic wand now on the courier in the stash. There's a tome on Phoenix. I feel like I've kind of forgotten about that item a little bit. And where's Arteezy? He's got a Midas. His courier is down because of the Night Stalker. Over at top, Vengeful Spirit gets stunned up by the lion, and the control is there. Doesn't even use the finger for it. Kefka's laying in wait for Eternal Envy. There's also a Nightstalker here. That combo can do quite a bit to him, and Eternal Envy is going to get off the lane. Pilot Die scouts out the Juggernaut, and the spin is there. Pilot Die trying to duke it out, but it's just not good enough. And there were not enough creeps there to tank up the damage from the Omni Slash. With an Exorcism, Death Prophet can go into the Roche Pit. Almost thought that they would try to kill the Roche, but Eternal Envy is forced back beneath his tower. I still think that Team Toast can go for Roshan, but Eternal Envy just rotates over to top, and they may smoke up, but they are right underneath the Dire Observer. They smoke up right underneath the Observer. And Team Toast know everything about this. They can react as well. Ravage still available from Tidehunter. Bulbu, he's at 1,000 gold. And Team Toast are just going to get away. Tower is under attack. And with that smoke, Secret go into Rosh. And when Team Toast see that they're not on the map at all, they may know about this Roshan attempt. And they don't have a scan. They do have, yeah, they do have vision of that with the heroes. I see Eternal Envy go back into the pit. They could react to this. Exorcism is available, as is the Chronosphere. Eternal Envy has to be careful using the Forge Spirit to tank things up, get the silence onto the Nightstalker. There's a cold snap as well. There's a Chronosphere. It hits on the three. And there's a beautiful Chronosphere from Kefka, but it doesn't do a whole lot of damage. Exorcism is there. They have to try to take down the Death Prophet, since she is the biggest threat here. And the cat is going to be used to heal up the Nightstalker. Baseless Void caught out a little bit on the backside. And they do back off. Death Prophet can go in with the Exorcism on the Roshan. He's at about half health. And the Exorcism will be completed soon. And Secret could go back in. The stun, or sorry, the silence misses. And Secret are going to take Roche. That's basically the rhythm. Drow Ranger picks up the Helm of the Dominator, and then they Roche. Uh, 13 minutes into the game, 4 kills to 1 for Team Toast, but Team Secret keeping this game very quiet. And with this quiet start, they may be looking pretty good here. The Centaur runs over towards the Secret, or the Ancients, maybe to stack it up. And Nightstalker is looking for something here. He could find Pilai Dai, who may take the death for his team. I see the Nightstalker. Nightstalker is going to silence Pilai Dai, go right for him, and he'll try to TP up. But the stomp is there from the Centaur. They get it. And the laser is there from the Phoenix. Just walking with the Centaur. A bit unlucky there for Nightstalker. But in the end, they do find the kill. The Nightstalker feeds one over. Radiant's top tower is under attack. It's not the worst kill that can happen for them. But now Team Secret, they're a little bit more free to go down mid lane, and with the Aegis on Drow Ranger, don't have too many cares here. Eternal Envy just can step up to the tower, do the damage. Drow Ranger is one of the heroes that he loves to play.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower.
And here they go, they've taken down the tower. Drow Ranger backs up. Still have a Ravage. They haven't seen too many of them. They're going to find the Ancient stack. Can start to take it down. They've taken down the tier 2 tower at mid. There's only 3 outer towers remaining for Team Toast. And this is kind of what this Drow lineup is supposed to do. It's what it's designed for. Puppy will TP over to top. And there's an Omni Slash available. Cat is going to heal up Juggernaut, but he's taking so much damage from the Sunstrike, a little bit off the mark. Solana's inside the trees. Team Toast are just all over the map trying to create some kind of space against Team Secret. Radiant structures are fortified. And Puppy has to be careful. This tower is going to go down pretty well. The laser comes out. Phoenix ready to go away. He does get stunned up by the Vengeful Spirit. And Drow Ranger showed up. Now, though, they're going on to Kefka. Kefka has the Chronosphere available, but he won't be able to get it off because he's just sunstruck down. A bit too far from his team. He was waiting for Envy to get out of there or some kind of advantage that he could use to go on a Team Secret, but it just was not there. And that's a 600 gold change the way of Team Secret. If we look at the XP and gold right now, going to be 3,000 for XP, and the gold is at about 4,000. Valve Discord finish on Death Prophet. And there's a Yasha on Juggernaut in addition to 1,500 gold. Envy right now is... he's got a Dragonlance being delivered by the Courier. Four Spirits are trying to take down the Courier, not quite able to find it. And the Courier, the Anibi, is going to live another day. Bulbu has an Invis rune. Getting deep here. Looking for someone. Cat will follow Juggernaut, healing him up. He's going to try to TP away. And he is going to get out. Nothing there to stop him. Tier 1 tower goes the way of Secret. And they could go for the Tier 4. They're just taking most of the map control out of here. And this is going to help them with the net worth. Bulbu scouting out Kefka at mid. And Arteezy finds the Faceless Void over at mid, just kind of taking him out there while Secret, Eternal Envy, and Arteezy will take out the top tier 2 tower, and they may even go for the base with Faceless Void down for 27 seconds, or at least force out a buyback. Now, Ravage is down, it was used for that kill on the Faceless Void. And Team Secret seem to have the upper hand here against Team Toast. The kills are even, but the net worth firmly in favor of Team Secret as it keeps just going up on that line up to 7,500. We're only 18 minutes in. Nolan is a bit far forward. Lion's ready. Pylodite has a blink. Colonel Envy, he's gonna get scouted out. Do they go in on him? Lion blinks in, gets a stun. There's a Sunstrike there, and it will end up finishing off the Defenseful Spirit. That's a dominating streak for Arteezy. Working very well on the around the Invoker Sunstrike, and the Aegis gets reclaimed. Colonel Envy gonna have to be more careful in the future, but he is getting items delivered to him. A Yasha and a Dragonlance. Very big items for him. Going to go into the Lion goes into the trees. Artur right now sitting on 10,000 net worth. He's got a boots of travel and he's working very quickly towards an Aghanim Scepter. Lion's creating so much space. This is what Pylodai does. He just knows exactly where on the map he can be, and he's gonna create so much space. Team Toast are smoked up, looking for anything that they can try to get. Someone's looking for it, but there's no one even there. Team Secret are basically all at top except for Arteezy. He's at the Ancients. Are they going to walk over there? They have no vision there. They basically found nothing in the Radiant Jungle, and their smoke is over. Even through all that, Secret are going to back away from the top lane. Even though they could force out a few TPs. Faceless Void has a Blink Dagger in addition to his Chronosphere. He's almost level 11. Veil and Jewels on Death Prophet. And Team Secret, they only have one outer tower to take down, but we'll see if they end up going for the base. They're just kind of sitting in each other's jungles right now. Smoke is going to be there. And Dire don't have vision of that smoke. Go over to mid. They could catch him from behind. Death Prophet is in the area. Ganon's gonna be off the mark. I feel like they just switched sides of the map here. Arteezy continues to be alive at the Ancients, and they go back into Roche. Just waiting here, waiting on the low ground. Might be a very bad engagement for them, but most of Team Toast are back in the base, and the Wolf is going to scout out Vengeful Spirit. Here comes the Drow Ranger. Silence is going to be there. Vengeful Spirit runs away from the Sunstrike, not really going to help her a whole lot. They just kite the Vengeful Spirit, don't let her get the stun off, and they've taken her down. Maybe not the best kill that they could be looking for there, but it is a kill nonetheless. And here we go. Lion's looking for something. He's going to get Silence up. Done. Beautiful Silence by Drow Ranger. He's going to get a double there. Ravage is there. It hits on the two. And they just completely clean up the Faceless Void. No Chronosphere for this one. Exorcism continues to go. There's a Hex on the Stuff style. Pylodi gets a stun and a finger. They're going right for the Night Stalk. Can they take him down? Yes, indeed. Drow Ranger is going to get the kill onto him. And now they go right down mid. They have the damage here. They say, Eternal Enemy, come on, please, hit the base. But back from Nightstalker, and the Exorcism, it's also completed, or it's almost completed. It's going to be expiring right now. Darkness gets used. They've taken down the Tier 3 tower. They could break the base right here. They had a 60-minute plus match in the round of 16, but now Team Secret, they are running right through Team Toast. Eternal Envy could get silenced. There's going to be a Yule Scepter up in the sky, and the Chronosphere will be there on the three. Puppy gotten silenced. No ball for this one if they get it, and he will end up dying. But another beautiful silence by Eternal Envy. See if the Juggernaut is able to chase him down. Eternal Envy needs help from his team. Juggernaut is silenced, and now he's going to be there. Nice block by Pylodi. He's going to take the spin for his team. And Eternal Envy, he's going to try to get some kill or damage on the Juggernaut. Juggernaut's trying to get away, and okay, the beautiful silence by the Night Stalker ends up helping the Juggernaut find the kill, but he will end up in the base. Now Arteezy, forced to back away from the Death Prophet, goes invisible, and the little kitty is cheering on the entire Dire side, so happy about everything. You might not want to be so happy about that one, even though his team did come up ahead in 1100 gold for that fight. And they do protect the racks.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Buyback ends up being worth it from the Faceless Void. It took a couple of heroes from Team Secret down, and it did end up stop the Supernova from being able to be used. Very good Chrono from him. Bulbu working around the map. He's actually at 3,500 gold right now. He's somehow amassed quite a bit. Blink Dagger and Aghanim Scepter finished up on Invoker. Still at 1,200 gold. And there is now a Mantis style on Drow Ranger just to deal with the Death Prophet silence. Faceless Void ready with another Chrono in 30. And here come a Team Secret down the bottom lane, going to go for that last remaining outer tower. And the Forge Spirit's going to be doing some great damage to it. See if Lion is able to catch anyone out. Vengeful Spirit is going to run right away from this one. The tower goes down. Arteezy is going to take it, and he blinks away. Now Roshan is available. They tell Eternal Envy to get over here. Bulbu is going to start the Roshan. And Eternal Envy just going to walk right in. Nice alacrity for the Drow Ranger. Needs possibly a little bit more survivability against this Team Toast combo. Exorcism and Chronosphere can be very good. And here they go. Steph Style is smoked up inside the base. Eternal Envy is able to get out. Roshan again. Down to half health. Exorcism available from Death Prophet. Chronosphere is also there. And an Omni Slash. Team Toast have basically everything they need to try to fight this.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
And they're just going to sit around here. Puppy uses his Midas. Wow.
Radiant's middle tower.
And we are just waiting here for someone to step on someone's toes. Sunstrike is going to scout out Roshan. And they're really looking for Vision here. Force Spirit goes to the high ground. We'll see the Night Stalker, but now nighttime is over. And they could go forward onto this, but it could be a trap. Swap in. Vengeful Spirit gets a stun onto Eternal Envy, but it is going to take the fall here. And now Lion goes forward. Finger onto Night Stalker. He's put up into the sky. And Steph Style is dead style. He's out of here. That will be the entrance for Team Secret back into the Roche Pit. And Roshan is not going to be allowed to live for long. This is kind of how these fights go. Envy goes into the pit, they go out, something happens, they win a fight, and they go back in. And Tidehunter still has a Ravage. He's also going for a Refresher very quickly. And they could go on to Kafka. Kafka, Blink, Ravage is available, definitely blast off the mark. Are they going to use it? Do they even need it? 1 second on the time walk. And Kefka goes into the trees. Blink available is available in a couple seconds. Blink dagger is there, rather. And they don't get him. They don't want to use the Ravage for it. They are just going to let the purple guy get away. Envy was also doing some good damage over at the top lane. Flens is trying to get away from the duo of Puppy and Pywidai. The laser's going to be a bit off the mark. And Puppy's just going to fly around, get some vision. And the kitty goes down. Puppy has to take it out. And Flens puts the kitty into the trees. Meanwhile, at mid, Eternal Envy has been silenced up, still has the Aegis. Swap is available from Vengeful Spirit. Aegis Void is going to get a beautiful 3-man chrono. Now, that's probably going to get rid of the Envy Aegis, and they silence up Arteezy. There is a beautiful Ravage, 3-man Ravage from Bulba, and they do take down Faceless Void. Now they're going right for the Death Prophet. They need to take her down. This Exorcism is too much. Eternal Envy from the low ground. He's trying to take down the Death Prophet, and he may be going down here. He's on the wrong side of this. Damage in, beautiful tornado from Arteezy, but the Void is there to take down Eternal Envy. The supports were not there for that one. Drow's going to buy back. Eternal Envy really wants into this one. His TP to the mid lane to just push this in as fast as possible. They want to force buybacks, I guess. Interesting buyback by him. I guess they want to keep putting pressure on. And seeing that the Exorcism and Chrono and Omnislash is down, there are not a whole lot of tools for Team Toast to defend this. So they put Envy on the high ground. If he dies here, though, I mean, that would be nothing short of extremely bad. Antistyle gets used. Eternal Envy with the Alacrity from inside the outside the base. Just going to be doing damage. Deathstyle has the doesn't use the silence. Needs to be a little bit closer for that one. Forge Spirit is going to get healed up by Phoenix. And here comes Night Stalker. Kafka in the middle of everything uses a time dilation. There's the spin. Lobu trying to get away from it. Force Staff is there. Arteezy. And not Arteezy, but he does get a Force Staff in. Pywidai is going to be dead. Now Secret most likely have to get out. First BKB from Juggernaut. And Puppy's going to be able to TP away. Eternal Envy, if they can get a kill here, is definitely worth it. And there is an Omni Slash available, but here comes Tidehunter. He's ready. He's gotten the Anchor Smash, and the Eternal Envy going to stand strong. Needs to go through the wall. Blue Scepter up in the sky. They need to defend this. Eternal Envy, if he goes down, and he will. Bulbu not even close. Now there's another Refresher. Okay, Refresher delivered. And there's going to be the Ravage. There's the Supernova. They turn it around. Here comes Arteezy. Does he have a stun? Doesn't even matter. They have enough damage. They take down 4 at mid. And here they go back down the mid lane. And they want to finish off that melee Rax. Arteezy is ready for this. Puts the Midas onto the creep, and he's going to go for the first set of Rax in the game. The melee Rax is going to put Team Toast on a bit of a disadvantage. There is no Fortify for this, and here come the Forge Spirits. Death Prophet has to take him out. There's a cold snap, and the Forge Spirits turn their attention back to the Rax. Bulba was up here. Tank up a little bit. And Lion, there's a Finger and the Sunstrike. They've taken down the Death Prophet. She has a buyback. The Chrono on a couple of heroes. Faceless Void goes in the middle of everything. His chrono's down for 110 seconds. And Pywidai and Tide, they just focus on the Rax. Taken down by Arteezy. And Secret, do they get a disengage? Kefka's looking for something. But he continues to get hit by these Forge Spirits. He needs a time walk to get back into the base. And these pesky little Forge Spirits are going to get taken out. And the Rax are down. A good fight from Team Secret. They turn it around even with Envy going down, and it almost makes it like his buyback never happened, or his dieback, I guess. So he gets that timer taken off of him, and his team does pretty well. Arteezy right now at a BKB and a soul booster. And Envy's just sitting on a Manta style. Team Toast may think like they may feel like they have to do something here because of their racks being down. I think they have to go for some kind of advantage. If they can get Envy down, that's going to be no buyback from him. It's weird that we're talking about so many of those 31 minutes into the game. That's just how it is. PyYDot again, very far up. And he's got... Did he get any scouting? No, he's just back. And he did get a little bit of vision of the Vengeful Spirit there. But he's just got some very good game sense, and that's how he plays. Creates space on the map. And he punishes the enemy for not paying attention. In terms of net worth, Secret are 20,000 ahead of Team Toast, and for XP, around 14,000. A little bit less. The big levels are up in them, and only the Death Prophet has made it to level 16 for Team Toast. Secret are walking around here. Remember that after this match, we will go into the best of threes in the semifinals. The winner will move on. Still very many hours out from the America's qualifier. And Lion continues to push out top, nearly solo. Arteezy is at bottom. He's got Boots of Travel. Secret may be setting up a push around top, but I have a feeling they're just going to wait for Roche. Going to respawn at some point, and when it does, it's going to be Aegis and Cheese this time. Flens walks forward at top. He's being very aggressive, has a spin available, and I think he knows that there's not really a whole lot that Secret can do about him if he gets a spin off. Team Secret laying in wait here. Nightstalker, he's at an Aghanim Scepter. Can someone give him a gem? Secret laying around the mid lane. Bottom is pushing in. Top a little bit further out. And at this point, Team Toast need their team fight to actually come to fruition. If they just let Team Secret get their initiation, let Envy do his thing, they're gonna take too much damage. And they're smoked up here. Could go into the base. I have to be wary of going too deep. Roshan respawns in 3 minutes, but they're not going to wait for it. Pretty long respawn for him. So even if they do die here, Roshan wouldn't really be up in time for Team Toast to actually take the Aegis and Cheese. And they have to be worried about top, because Flens is pushing it in. He's going to TP away now. That may make Secret think that they don't have to worry about the push a whole lot. Next item could be soon on Envy. He's at 2400 gold right now, and they've just taken down a stack of Ancients. Still waiting for where the engage is going to come from. And that's going to be a pause. Alright, cool. So it gives me a little bit of a break from the action. 20 kills to 10, 34, almost 35 minutes in. And Team Secret pushing into the base, seeing if they can break anything. Puppies complete a Shiva's guard, and they're gonna go with this. Bulba has that pressure off cooldown. Octarine Core finished on Invoker. And there's a couple of BKBs for Team Toast. Trying to stay away from that Ravage of Bulba. As well as Lion. So here we go. We are ready to go here into the match. And Team Secret, I still have a feeling that they're going to wait for the Roshan to do anything. The smoke might have betrayed them a little bit. And now there is the Aghanim Scepter and Gem picked up by the Night Stalker. So he's going to have quite a bit of vision here. And we take a look at this right now. It is daytime, so pretty normal. But Arteezy could get caught out at some point if he doesn't know about it. And Night Stalker hasn't showed himself right now. The line is still at the base. So he now puts the darkness out, and we can see how much vision the Dire see because of this. All of that vision. They're going to immediately smoke up. And they're going to find a couple of wards on their way. Just going to go right past them. Team Toast walking down the river into the Radiant Jungle. And with that darkness being popped, I think Team Secret know that it's time to back up. Forge Spear is creating a lot of pressure into the base from the creeps, and that may force Team Toast back. And Team Secret, they also have a smoke. And they could be ready to go in. Still going on with this game where it's 36 minutes in. And teams are kind of playing a little tete-a-tete here.
Dire's structures are fortified.
Fortify is already going to be used here as the creeps are pushing in on the tier 3. The tower almost down to the catapult. Going to take one or two more hits, and the Drow Ranger illusions are there to take it out, so that's a tier 3 down. And Steph Style, he's going forward here. Arteezy has to know about this gem. He's definitely going, it's going to affect his position on the around the map. There's going to be a tornado in. It does hit the Death Prophet, picked up into the air. There is no initiation off the back of it. Tidehunter, he spits on a creep, and he blinks away. Team Secret do not want to get caught out, and they're going to have the three amigos blinking away from the action. Silence is also going to be there, trying to see if they can find something. Force Spirits are going to just put a lot of harass out here. There's also an Ogre Frost Mage. I know Envy likes this creep a lot. He's going to be buffing up his team with it. And here they go. Exorcism still available. Darkness is going to be there. Arteezy, he's looking for the initiation. Not going to find it just yet. He'd actually... Look how little they see. They're not even seeing past this ramp that much. But we keep going. Both teams really unwilling to try to take a fight right now. We could find the Juggernaut. Lion is ready. He gets the stun. The Hex. Dawn is there. Sunstrike on the mark. Ravage is also there, but Chronosphere has also been used. And there's another Ravage available, but he's forced to use the Battle Fury. So at least the Refresher goes on cooldown. They have another Ravage if they need it. This boy does get the leap away. Now they go. Okay, there's a definitely blast. Steph Style taking so much damage. He's going down. Arteezy is beyond godlike somehow. And that's an Exorcism and BKB baited out from Death Prophet. The ghosts are going to be spooky. The ghosts are going to be doing some damage here. But Secret once again. They bait it out and they back out. Playing around these ultimates too well. And they go over to top. It shows a bit of the weakness of Team Toast lineup. They have all those ultimates, and once they're down, their team is a lot less scary. Envy goes right for the Rags, he takes down the pair top, and the effigies are going down. Now only bottom left for the Megas. And Team Toast have to make a stand here. Exorcism is available. Chronosphere in 50. And the Roshan's up. So they go for Rosh. TZ's at 13, 1, and 7. Scythe of Vice is there. Octarine, BKB. They've got all their items that they need. They're gonna take him down very quickly. The scan is there, they know about this. Chronosphere not there just yet. And the tornado does hit a little bit. Guard Ranger keeps the Aegis. Remember that they still have a Ravage and Tidehunter's taking the cheese. Void goes into the pit. They don't have vision of him there. He's gonna play around a little bit. And look at this, Arteezy, he's going for the base. If they engage here, I have a feeling that Arteezy is just going to go for it. Chronosphere on the two Pai Wai Dai and Puppy. It's a pretty good two right there. Good silence. And the Shivan's Guard is going to be there. And a beautiful Ravage on the 4 by Bulbul. He just comes right in. And the Deathwing Blast is there from Arteezy. They've taken down the Death Prophet. That's a huge kill for them. Now they go into Steph Dao's finger there. And Flens, there is nothing he can do about that one. Triple kill. Beyond Godlike for Arteezy. And Team Toast on their last legs. Dire's middle tower is they just became Burnt Toast. Team Secret walking down the bottom lane, a much easier game for them than the last one against Pro Dota, and they're looking like a semi-final team, and possibly like they could be in the regional qualifier. They're gonna have two best of threes to go through if they need that, or if they want to do that. Stolen getting taken out over near mid, and yeah, RTZ's found another kill. Not as important, but is going to force out the GG. Team Toast are gonna be out of this one in the quarterfinal. Good run from them. But Team Secret, they've made a couple of roster changes and it seems to be working for them, working their way through the open qualifier and into the semi-final. We'll be back in a couple minutes with that, see where the rest of the matches are. But for now, stay tuned. I'm on twitch.tv/pithynugoom.